This is something that was from 1984. As you tell, that's the original SC on TV sticker. Obviously, I got this at Goodwill for like $3.99. Obviously, this is, I'm sure this was more in value than that back in the 80s, but you know. And if you can believe it, a Kmart sticker. Sticker. No, I'm saying this sticker got a little bit torn off a little bit. It's up originally, so the part that was still there before, tech before, because somebody was inking on it. It was from, sold at Kmart in 1986. Like a little grater there at this thing, also different things. And it says cuts thin, medium, and thick slices. Cuts giolini's, if I'm pronouncing that right, and French fries. And that's what caught my eye. I can make my all natural organic French fries. It sheds, shreds, and minces. Includes slicer frame with sharp stainless steel cutter blade, pronged safety. Two double-sided guides and French fry cutter, plus two bonus hand tools. I'm gonna open up and box it and hope that all the parts are there. When I bought it to the store, it opened up a little bit, but I taped it, so I think it looked like it had all the parts, so I'm hoping so, especially something like this. Old technology, that's gonna be like I buy. I have all sorts of old technology, like simple. It's simple. It's cheaper. I mean, I bought technology that was never used. Cassette tape players and stuff like that, or cassette tapes. And they're, since they're, you know, they're cheap, because there's just no, there's not a huge want or need for it. You can buy these things dirt cheap, and you can buy ones that have never been opened dirt cheap, because, you know, there's not a high need for it. And they sold so many, and were mass produced so much that the value is just, isn't that good. So you can get them for pretty dirt cheap. That's why I save, that's another way, of course. Money saving ways. But for me, I grew up old fashioned. Like, I grew up the old fashioned way of everything. So for me, having old fashioned technology, it's similar. You know, and it's just, in a way, it's just easier in general, really, too. These pair of keys to unlock it. That's just to unbox it. Old General Motors keys. It was either to my grandmother's car or my grandfather's car, truck, but I can't remember. I can't remember exactly. I use that just to open it up all. Because it could be one of that. My grandfather used to have a 1969 Chevy Chevelle Super Sport. And, but that was like years ago. And then my grandmother had a 1969 Chevy Camaro RS. She had like this like sky blue, and it had like, at first it was sky blue, but then eventually like a, it was like somewhere around the 80s, early 80s she got, or somewhere like that, somewhere in the 80s, she got a white stripe. So like, she said that the white stripes weren't available till like, I don't know, I think like 70s or 80s, something like that. I think 80s I want to say, but I'm not sure. I don't do white stripes because I think it looks tanky, but you know, she likes to do white stripes on the cars. Even though, you know, white stripes are generally, from a car standpoint, the reason why they have white stripes just like that is because it helps the driver to keep the car straight when driving. So it's basically just a race car technique, a race car driver technique to help them drive better, and that's it. Like, it's not like a sporty thing, or people say it's a sporty thing, but really, it's just a practical thing for race cars. Otherwise, for a street car, there's not really much of a sense in doing it. Maybe if you have a student driver, maybe, because then they can help keep the car straight and learn, maybe, I could see that, but besides that, I just think it's kind of tacky, it looks kind of funny, but anyway, this bad boy up, and this is the original box, too, from, you know, from 84, so you can tell the box is torn up, it's, like, really old, it's faded a little bit, I mean, it's, you know, It probably saw much better days back in 1984. But, no. But it looks like everything should be in there, which would be nice. It's a little noisy, so I'm going to try to open it. Do it a little slowly so it's not so loud. That way I don't screw up the ASMR quality. I have to do this video all over again. I have ideas for videos I want to do. So I'm going to make sure I'll screw it up at the same time. It's on lots of parts. Look at that, the nice blade. Now, of course, I am careful. You never want to touch this part, or else you're going to get a really bad cut. So obviously, though, I'm scratching it right by the edge. But never want to touch it. I did that much younger. My finger wouldn't stop bleeding for the longest time. It was bleeding for a good 5-10 minutes. It was crazy. So you definitely don't want to do that. And that was stupid back then because I was a kid at the time, so I didn't know. But I didn't know, unfortunately, I just wasn't using my head at the time. It looks like I may be missing a blade here, maybe, but I mean, this is still. It just makes good sounds too. And that cut's already there because sometimes I move my hands like that, you know, due to my disabilities. So my hands get a little off and I was irritated and sore. But it definitely is sharp. I could tell if I did it faster, I would cut my skin. So it's definitely a good. I got this. It's a little bit sharp. It's more rough and dull than it is, you know, sharp. I got this part. Obviously, everybody knows what this is. Or for young kids, may not know. This is like what you call a cheese grater, or just a grater in general. Where you take some get little shavings of it. Best use of cheese, but you could probably use for other things. But that's, you know, generally what it's used for. And of course, if kids, you always gotta be careful and keep this somewhere safe, since they can get hurt on this technology. You know, so definitely, I want my kids to want me to say. Actually, don't want to make the same mistake I did when I was a kid. I hurt myself on these things. Hey, that hurts like all heck. This is sharp a little bit, but I mean, you know, sharp enough to get the job done. Miracle slicer. I think. Is it miracle? Yeah, miracle slicer. That's about it. There's nothing else in there. I don't mind the messy table. It goes to my grandparents' house. And like I said, the other day, my grandma's a bit of a, you know, unfortunately, a bit of a hoarder, unfortunately. So it's, the table's a bit messy. Parts. Get this part. Get this part. Get the green, everything that I was just showing before. Got this part, whatever the heck that is. I had to look at the instructions to figure it all out. Get this part. And you obviously got this part. It depends on what kind of slice you want to get. And that makes sense for French fries, which is obviously this part right here, which is probably what I'll be using the most. So if you are an X generation, and your next generation, or the baby boomer generation, whatever generation you're from, and you remember this, let me know down below in the comments below. These are good ones that last forever. I'm hoping it's a old technology that lasts a long time. I have some technology actually. I have like a Sanyo fat screen TV. I don't know what they're actually called, but that's the issue. Me and my friends and my family call it, fat screens. Where they have like the big box part on the back of the TV. It's, I don't know what we call it, but people in my area, we always call it a bomb. The fat screen TVs. We had that for like over 20 years. It still works perfectly fine with no problems. So we got a lot of technology. I make a cassette tape player from Radio Shack. That's like from somewhere around like 70s, 80s, whenever cassette tapes were popularized. Somewhere around there. You have to look at it exactly. And I think it still works like a charm. It works. It's not broken or anything. It actually works perfectly good. I got cassette tapes that are really old. They're really old. And I mean, they still work like a dream without screwing up. Now, of course, some do screw up because they're, from collectors who just didn't take good care of them. But for people I bought them from, did take care of them. I mean, they still work perfectly fine. There's no problems, and even the film is really good. And I have ones that were used a lot by somebody, and they still work perfectly like a charm. And it's so cheap to buy old technology. So I'm like, why would I buy new technology? It's like what, $50, $70, $500, $600, like crazy, these huge, incredible amounts of money. When you could buy something that's as simple. $3-$4, and the best part is it was Goodwill Blue Day, so this was actually 40% off, so I saved even more. So I mean, I saved money. I got something that you can buy in modern day, but a heck of a lot cheaper. And the depreciation this has, for the most part, the depreciation is already done with. What's the worst to happen? If it were to be sold, it'd be for what? So, of course, another reason to, but, I mean, there's a whole bunch of reasons, obviously, but, if this is it for this video, try to stretch it as long as I could, since there's not a whole lot to do with this, so I obviously try to stretch it as long as I can, that way, it's a somewhat long video, so hope you enjoyed this video, remember to like, comment, subscribe, and remember to share my videos, so that others will see my ASMR videos. Enjoyed this video, and why not subscribe to the channel if you're new? Subscribe here, you're trying to reach my subscribe, good stuff. And post the bell icon, ding, because then that'll notify you of new videos. So, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in a very